Now we can see some electronic displacements in the covalent bonds of the organic compounds. So organic compounds are generally covalent compounds. Covalent compound is formed by the mutual sharing of electrons, that we are aware. So electronic displacement means, if you consider any covalent bond between two general atoms A and B, so each atom gives one electron to its sharing. So under so here it is marked. So dot refers to electron of A, let us assume. Cross refers to electron of B. So dot and cross are put together by means of a line for a covalent bond. Here under certain conditions it can be broken. The breaking phenomenon of a covalent bond is called fission. So fission of a covalent bond is called breaking of a covalent bond between two atoms. If the fission is of two types, homolytic fission and heterolytic fission. Lytic means decomposition. So decomposition taking place along with the breakage of covalent bond. So homolytic, homo means same, hetero means different. So homolytic fission means after breakage each atom goes with its electron. For example, A goes with its unpaired electron, B so pairing is done during covalent bond formation. During breakage, if A goes with its unpaired electron and B goes with its unpaired electron, these are called radical A and radical B, systems with unpaired electrons. So homolytic fission results in the formation of unpaired electrons, that is species with unpaired electrons. These are called radicals. Whereas heterolytic fission means one of the atoms will be more electronegative. Here let us assume that B is more electronegative than A. In such case, it will attract the A's electron pair itself towards it. So if A's electron goes to B, A becomes positively charged and B becomes negatively charged. So ions are formed. In general, homolytic fission results in the formation of free radicals. Free radicals are systems with unpaired electrons. Heterolytic fission is the breakage of covalent bond leading to, where the total shifting of pair of electrons is towards one of the more electronegative atom. So it results in the formation of ions, cations and anions are radicals, cations, anions, all these are transient intermediates. Transient intermediates means which exists for a while. Immediately they will recommence. So radical means at the hydrogen radical is reactive. That is why it combines with another hydrogen radical to form hydrogen molecule. Oxygen radical is reactive. That is why it reacts with another oxygen radical to form oxygen molecule. So A plus B minus. A plus means positive charge. B minus means negative charge. Opposite charges attract each other. So they tend to nullify, they form a covalent bond. All these species are transient intermediates which exist for a while and immediately recombine. So now these effects involving these transient intermediates. So electronic displacements of a covalent bond in an organic compound may be of these types. N of these types. First type is called inductive type. Second effects are called inductive effect, electromeric effect, resonance effect and hyperconjugation effect. Inductive effect, electromeric effect, hyperconjugation and resonance. Now inductive effect is denoted as plus psi and minus psi grouping effect is called. So electron donating groups are called inductive plus psi groups, electron donating groups. For example, alkyl groups, it will donate electrons. So alkyl groups will donate electrons. Methyl group, ethyl group. So these are examples of plus psi effect, such as alkyl groups, alkyl in general, alkyl substituted amines formula is NH2. So NH2, alkyl amines, mono substituted amines, disubstituted amines is NR2. These donate electrons. So electron donating species, they are called plus psi effects. Whereas electron, so these are groupings. we have to remember that all these are only groupings. These are, none of them is a compound. So these are groupings. Electron donating groupings are called plus inductive effect grouping. They are identified as plus I effect. So examples of plus I groups with plus I effect are methyl, ethyl, alkyl, alkyl amino, amino groups. Whereas other types of groups such as, so electron withdrawing groups are called minus I effect. So electron withdrawing group. So if these groups are present, they withdraw, accept electron from the adjacent carbon atom, that is called electron withdrawing. Nitro group, hydroxyl group, even carboxyl group, halogen group. Halogens are more electronegative, we are aware. So these groups, electron withdrawing group. So electron withdrawing group, they are called minus I effect groupings. Electron donating group, so in books you will see these captions EDG, EWG. EDG means electron donating groups, EWG electron withdrawing groups. So plus I effect or inductive, minus I effect or inductive effect in general arises due to the electron donating or electron accepting capacity or electron withdrawing. Electron withdrawing, it is not electron accepting, electron withdrawing capacity from the adjacent carbon atoms by the groups. That is called inductive effect. Now we will see the what is meant by electromeric effect. So all these are due to covalent bonds. Just be borne in mind. Electromeric effect is observed for multiple bonded systems. In multiple bonded systems, for example, carbonyl group, not necessarily only carbon-carbon, carbon-oxygen, whatever be the case. So carbon-carbon multiple bond is there, carbon-oxygen multiple bond is there. In double bond, we know that one bond is sigma bond, another bond is pi bond. Pi bond is weaker than sigma bond. If it is weaker, that electrons, pi electrons will be shifting towards more electronegative atom. Of these two specimens, oxygen is more electronegative than carbon. So the pi electrons both of carbon and oxygen shift towards oxygen. If carbon's electron shifts towards oxygen, carbon becomes plus and oxygen minus becomes minus. Now after this electromeric effect, cyano group attacks this species. Carbonyl CO group is called carbonyl group. Cyano group attacks. Here cyanide is negatively charged, carbon is positively charged, opposite charges attract each other. So carbon immediately attaches to cyano group, oxygen exists as O minus. So this results in the formation of negatively charged species. So it is called minus E effect or minus electromeric effect. Another example, so similarly is the case with carbon chlorine. Chlorine will be more electronegative, it will be becoming C plus, Cl minus, some other group will attach. Now alkenic bonds, C double bond C, this is only intermediate, that is to be noted. So if this shifts towards one atom, pi electrons, pi bond is weaker, pi bond shifts towards one atom. The question may arise, both the atoms are equally powerful, where will it shift? So it will shift also towards right side carbon atom or left side carbon atom, that is reflected in resonance later. No, if let us assume that it is shifted towards right. If it shifts towards right, left side carbon atom becomes positively charged, right side carbon atom becomes negatively charged, and proton attacks this carbon-carbon double bond, means proton is getting attached to second carbon atom. So proton is positively charged, second carbon atom is negatively charged. So it is, this results in the formation of positively charged intermediate. So this is called plus E effect or plus electromeric effect. So electromeric effect arises due to the shifting of pi electrons towards more electronegative atom, If the atoms are of equally powerful, that will reflect in resonance, followed by attack of some other species, nucleophile or electrophile, to get a near species. If the near, all these are transient, it is not a combo. CCNO minus is not a combo. It will be later converted COHCN, cyanohydrin, like that. So it is minus I effect. So if the resultant species is a negatively charged species, it is an example of minus E effect or electromeric effect. Resultant species is a positively charged, it is called plus E effect. So these are the two important types of effects, namely electromeric and inductive effects. Next important type of effect is the resonance effect. So resonance means it arises due to the delocalization of electrons. So resonance means delocalization of electrons. Delocalization means delocalization of pi electrons. Pi electrons are not fixed in position, so they are moving around the benzene ring. Already we have seen the examples of benzene. So benzene can be represented in this fashion. Here there are three double bonds. These are pi bonds. Three pi bonds are there. Each bond contains two electrons. 3 × 2, 6 pi electrons are there. This is structure 1. Structure 2 we can write in this fashion. It is, they are another way. This is also, structure 2 also contains 6 pi electrons. So means that pi electrons were between 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Between first carbon atom and second carbon atom, single bond in one structure, whereas between first carbon atom and second carbon atom, double bond in another structure. So the pi electrons are getting delocalized. So this delocalization phenomenon is called resonance. Delocalization of pi electrons or unpaired electrons are involved in resonance. Let us illustrate the phenomenon of resonance in phenol. Phenobenzene is C6H6 and one hydrogen atom is replaced by OH grouping. This is called phenol. Oxygen has two lone pairs of electrons. Here we have 1, 2 lone pairs of electrons, alternate double bonds. Now this lone pair of electron is shifted towards the carbon atom, and these pi electrons are shifted towards next carbon atom. First lone pair of electrons of oxygen, this is only temporary arrangement. Here the no question of electronegative phenomenon. Oxygen is more electronegative, but oxygen has two lone pairs of electrons, that's why it is getting shifted. So shifting of lone pair of electrons towards the ring contains, so towards the ring, and pi electron, one of the pi electrons shift towards next. If it is shifted towards in this fashion, here it is getting shifted, means there is an establishment of double bond between the oxygen and benzene ring. Since the pi electron are shifted towards this carbon atom, the next carbon atom becomes negatively charged. Oxygen's electrons are going to the ring, it becomes positively charged. That is why it is mentioned as OH plus and carbon minus. This is first resonating structure. This one, second resonating structure. Still it is not stable. Now this all carbon atoms are equally powerful. That is why this electron shifts towards next carbon atom. Next pi electron shifts towards. In this way we can write number of structures, not infinite number of structures. When you write the fifth structure will be same as that of first structure. So four possible structures are in the case of resonance of phenol. So phenol has four resonating structures. Higher the number of resonating structures, more stable is the compound. Benzene is highly stable because of the resonance. Benzene cyclohexane, which is more stable, means benzene will be more stable because of resonance. Last important phenomenon is called hyperconjugation. This is also delocalization of pi electron, not in the ring, in the open chain. That is the difference. between the resonance and hyperconjugation, both are delocalization of pi electrons or sigma electrons even in some cases, not in the ring, open chain compound. Now, here we are considering the sigma electron. So, CH3, CH2. So, this is propene. Propene contains one sigma, CH2. Here we have pi bond. Pi electrons are less weaker in nature. They are shifting towards one carbon atom. So, and also one of the sigma bond even gets shifts towards the carbon, because carbon is more electronegative than hydrogen. So, it tends to attract hydrogen's electron. So, the CH covalent bond shift towards CC. That is why there is an establishment of CC double bond in the right side. Initially, there was no double bond only in the next carbon atom. Here itself there is a carbon atom. So, C double bond, then it goes to next. Pi electrons are shifted towards next carbon atom, means one carbon atom becomes positively charged, that is hydrogen becomes positively charged, the atom gaining electron becomes negatively charged. So, these are called hyperconjugation. There is a shifting of pi electron as well as sigma electron. In open chain structures, this is hyper means above. Generally, we expect only for pi electrons. Here, sigma electrons also getting involved in the resonance phenomenon, but only in the open chain structure. So, here also more number of hyperconjugating structures, more stable is the compound. So, the resonance and hyperconjugation are important in assessing the stability of the compound. Some compounds are more stable because of higher resonance. Some compounds are more stable because of hyperconjugation. So, these four effects, inductive, electromeric, resonance and hyperconjugation effects, will be finding application in understanding the mechanistic aspects of the reaction, which will be discussed in due course.